never think, I never know. I'm stuck and left alone. I've been lost, I've been fine. My cause is not defined. Won't you kiss me? Won't you play? Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. It's been a while, oh my. I believe it's around 3 months, 4 months I haven't uploaded a video. Well, there's something going on with my mom. So basically I have to take care of her. She's sick since 2019, but it's getting worse. But anyway, in today's vlog I'm going to bring you guys with me to my first dose of COVID-19 vaccination. It's my first dose.
Soalnya kalau ini apa?
Ya, tunggu waktunya aja udah. Jadi sebelum gua divaksin, gua pastiin diri gua bersih dari virus COVID-19. Dan di sini gua on the way ke Prodia to get myself tested, and it turned out that I'm negative from the COVID-19 virus. Oke, jadi di sini gue udah nyampe di tempat vaksinasi. Gue dapetnya itu di Holy Wings, Jakarta Selatan. Kebetulan nggak begitu banyak orang, karena mungkin pokoknya masih baru ya, jadi nggak banyak yang tahu. I got lucky there, nggak harus rebutan. So after the first queue, gue masuk ke dalam dan gue harus ngantri lagi. Gue dapat antrian baru.
Nomor antrian 103, 104.
Habis itu gue dipanggil untuk registrasi ulang, terus blood pressure test. Dan kalau semuanya udah oke, gue divaksin. Dan surprisingly I felt nothing, mungkin karena jarumnya sangat kecil ya. Di sini gue melihat proses gue disuntikan vaksin. Ya, yeah, it's a habit of mine. Jadi gue harus tahu gue diapain nih. Jadi gue harus liatin. So finally it's done. I got the jab. Now I'm in the observation state. I have to wait for 30 minutes. So after the vaccination, I have to hurry back to home because I don't really like to be outside at this moment, at this state. The COVID-19 is really bad right now, especially in Jakarta. Please get your vaccine as fast as possible. Well, it's for your own benefit, it's for your surroundings, for your family, for your friends. It's important. So yeah. Well, see you guys soon. Bye. Hi everyone. Well, this is the next day after the vaccination. Kemarin itu habis vaksin aku langsung pulang. Terus aku tidur. Tidurnya enak banget, nyenyak. Terus pegel-pegel juga enggak, karena aku minum paracetamol after I got the jab. Malamnya bangun karena ngurusin nyokap kan. Jadi gue hari ini itu bangun jam 4 pagi karena nyokap kebangun. Terus nyokap ya inilah apa manggil-manggil gitu. Ternyata apa pusing katanya. Jadi ya udah kasih obat. Terus aku ganti pampersnya mama juga. Terus aku siapin sarapan sekalian buat bokap nyokap, siapin obat juga. Itu pagi jam 6 tadi. Terus aku beres-beres dan sekarang jam 9. Kayaknya aku mau istirahat sih. So yeah, hari ini nggak ngerasain apapun. Bangun paginya enak, but I will update you guys besok lagi apakah ada simptom atau enggak. Setelah divaksin, jenis vaksin yang aku dapat itu adalah Sinovac. Tapi gue nggak peduli sih sebenarnya jenis vaksinnya apa, yang penting gue
the vaccine, even though that I already got infected last year. Aku udah cek antibody, udah mulai rendah antibodinya. Jadi ya udah, gue cepat-cepat nyari tempat vaksinasi. And then I got the jab. Hi guys, so this is the fifth day after the vaccination. I didn't get a chance to film the second, the third, and the fourth day because I've been busy taking care of my mom. I've been having a really hard time to sleep, and I felt tired. Well, you're supposed to get a lot of rest after the vaccination, but for some people, there's not an option for them, including me. I have to take care of both of my parents, especially my mom. So yeah, I've just felt tired. It's definitely something going on in my body. It's not fever, it's not something serious, it's just tiredness. I don't feel any sore or sort of things, but yeah, just tired, I think. Now about my mom. Sebenarnya mama udah sakit dari tahun 2017 dan divonis terkena tumor otak, and it's called lymphoma. Mama sempat sembuh dan di tahun 2019 she got sick again. Tapi kali ini mama divonis stroke. So I have to take care of her. Dan di tahun 2021 awal, my dad got small accident, sehingga papa harus dirawat di rumah. Posisinya papa di Jakarta. And I have to flew back to Jakarta with my mom. Karena waktu itu papa gak ada yang ngerawat. Papa sudah sembuh posisinya. Dan di bulan Juni akhir, keadaan mama memburuk. Dan ketika dirawat di rumah sakit, mama divonis terkena tumor otak kembali. Dan kali ini sama limfoma, tapi letak persisnya itu berbeda dengan sebelumnya dan berada di tengah otak. Dan mama gak bisa dioperasi. Setelah satu bulan mama dirawat, keadaannya mulai membaik. Mama ditreat dengan obat-obatan untuk mengecilkan pembengkakan yang terjadi di dalam otak. But things got bad when my mom caught COVID. Karena waktu itu kita ambil kelas kamar yang sharing. Kebetulan orang yang sekamar dengan mama dan orang yang menjaga tidak mematuhi protokol kesehatan. Tidak memakai masker. Dan yang menjaga keluar masuk rumah sakit dan masih ke acara yang banyak orangnya. Dan waktu itu Jakarta sedang mengalami kenaikan kasus COVID. Anyway, setelah pulang dari rumah sakit, mama sempat isoman 2 minggu di rumah. Walaupun mama tidak mengalami gejala yang berat, kadar oksigen mama semakin turun dari hari ke hari. Dan mengharuskan mama kembali dilarikan ke rumah sakit. Mama akhirnya diisolasi dan mama mengalami perburukan pada infeksi paru-parunya. Kabar terakhir, setelah mama 4 minggu isolasi, mama mulai membaik. Sama dengan keadaan sebelumnya yang tidak bergejala. Kadar oksigen mulai stabil dan kadar virus dalam tubuh mulai berkurang. So guys, I don't have a chance to do a daily update after the vaccination because I've been really busy taking care of my mom. And about vaccination, orang-orang itu suka salah kaprah. People tend to get a wrong information that when you got vaccinated that you are free from COVID, and that's not the case. So the purpose of the vaccination is to lower the risk that you got hospitalized or you got a severe symptoms. So okay, this is the end of the vlog, and I see you guys on my next video. Bye-bye.